Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to this webinar to introduce you the Electronic and Communication Engineering program. This is the program that I will follow today. After a brief introduction of myself, I will present the degree program, and then I will show what's in this ECE program, and then I will also talk about what are the opportunity beyond ECE and the strengths of ECE. Finally, I will conclude showing which are the methods to keep in touch with us today and also after. So let's first introduce myself. I am Andrea Carena. I'm the coordinator of the Electronic and Communication Engineering degree program. I am part of the Department of Electronic and Telecommunication and also part of the Collegio ETF, that means Electronics, Telecommunication and Physics. That is the structure that manage the didactics, the teaching in the area of ICT where the program belong. Here is my email, and is the best way to contact me, but at the end of this talk, you'll also see other methods to keep in touch to us and to get more info in case you are interested. How to interact with us today? You can write your question in the chat, so you can start now, you can do it while I'm talking. My talk it will last 15 to 20 minutes. We will start to answer at the end of my talk, okay? So you can use the chat that is in the column with the icon on your left. If you don't feel comfortable with the English, you can ask the question in Italian. We can then answer you in Italian or in English, no problem. In case your question is too complex, maybe at the end we can also have some, let's say, oral questions, but let's try to keep going with the chat. Okay. So now let's move to the presentation of the degree program, which are the main feature of the ECE program. It's a bachelor degree. If you are not familiar with the academic nomenclature, bachelor means laurea triennale, so or what it could be just laurea in following the ministry definition, and a program that we have here in Polito, so given in Torino. It is completely taught in English. It's a degree that is innovative. We have activated it in 2015, so 5 years ago. And also thanks to the fact that is completely taught in English, it has an international class of students. You can see some percentage here in the table of foreign students. We started with more than 30% and we reached in quickly in 3 years more than 50%, and this is the average of also of this year. I think this is a plus for a course of this type, especially because we see in the area of the ICT where this program is focused, it's important to learn English and to be able to fluently speak it in order to find a job. Other feature is that it's an interdisciplinary education in the field of information communication technology. What are information communication technology? It means everything that is related to the storage, retrieving, manipulation, and transmission of information in electronical and digital form. And this program blends electronics and telecommunication. So, as I said, it's interdisciplinary. This is a big advantage because it opens you to many opportunity for future master or for jobs. ICT are very pervasive in our society. Just to give you a number that I didn't put in my slide, for example, today almost 10% percent of the energy consumed in overall in the world is due to ICT services and devices. So it's a huge amount compared to other industries. The most popular outcome of ICT is internet. And you could ask yourself, what would our life have been like without the internet in this pandemic? I think everybody has an everyday use of internet. It has been exacerbated in these last 3 months. You did online teaching, you chatted online, you had a video call with your friends, with your family, and nothing would be possible without the rapid development of ICT. So this program is about this. So let's see what's in, sorry, what's inside EC in the program. So this is the EC recipe that we used to design the program. We have about one third of basic courses, math, physics, chemistry, that is the first year, that is almost in common with all other engineering programs, so this 37%. But then the remainder is almost equally split between courses in the area of telecommunication, electronics, and informatics, so programming and so. There are about 10% of free choice courses that you can select, and you can bend your, let's say, individual program more toward telecommunication or more toward electronics, properly selecting the free choices, okay? So let's go in the details of the study plan. This is the study plan. I could spend more than half an hour bothering you with details, course by course, programs, details, and but I prefer to avoid this. I don't have time, and I think it will just bother you, and maybe you will even leave the webinar. But let me do in a more practical and interesting way. So I will change from what's in ECE to what's in my smartphone. Everybody has a smartphone. You have a smartphone in your pocket. I think it's the most popular device today. And what I will do is to look inside your smartphone. So let's see what is in it. If you could open and disassemble it. So please don't do it, because today you can not even remove a cover of a smartphone. You have really to almost destroy it to look inside. You'll find many, many components. So let's see what we could find. First of all, there is the hardware. So what you can touch with your hand. So you'll find circuit boards, even flexible one, memory, chip, and a lot of sensors, accelerometer, gyroscope, magnetometer, barometer, and air humidity sensor, that are all made with most of semiconductor or similar technology. And all these refer to specific courses that we have in our program. For example, here I listed all the courses that are in the area of electronics, starting from a basic course that is circuit theory and application, where you start looking at the theory of circuits, and then moving from electronic device up to electronic circuits, and then to applied electronics. Then we have a course where you learn, let's say, transversally, how to make measurements, so electronic measurements. To conclude with a course that is actually optional, but you can have it, as a digital system electronic, to look at the whole digital system, okay? Then, looking into a little with a little more detail, is not so simple. In case you could really open your phone, you'll find many antennas, because there are many signals that are transmitted and received by your phone. Regular, let me say, cellular phone, 3G, 4G, LTE, then Wi-Fi. You receive GPS. There are Bluetooth, there is near field communication, NFC, that you typically use to pay, just putting the phone on the bank receiver. And for example, all these courses involve a lot of theory of electromagnetism. So you have to learn how electromagnetic waves are generated, transmitted, and they propagate in the air. And we have a course in electromagnetic waves and antennas that where you will learn all these things. And then moving to other hardware that do not involve exactly just hardware, because behind them there is a lot of software and very sophisticated algorithm. There are the transmitter and receiver, the so-called modem, modulator, demodulator. This is an acronym. And they involve also a lot of digital signal processing. This is the, let's say, the core of the telecommunication part. And so starting from the basic signal and systems, where you learn how to study and use signal to transmit information. Then there is a digital transmission course, where you will learn how to generate a signal that carry information in a digital way and how to transmit it to another place to receive it and to have this flow of information. And there is a course on communication network, where you will learn how to connect different devices to build a full network. And then, very important, we have also courses where these application of signal processing and digital communication are put in a lab, so you can really try and put your hands on this topic. And to conclude our trip inside the smartphone, we come to the software, so something that you cannot touch like the hardware, but is fundamental for the functioning of the phone. So first of all, there is an operating system and many apps that you can install and have for you. And consider that today's smartphone, compared to, for example, to the processor that sent the man to the moon, is much more powerful. So you have more computational capacity in a today microprocessor that is in your smartphone than the one that was used in Apollo mission for sending a man to the moon. Okay, so to summarize, I can come back to what's in ECE and highlighting in red the courses that I just described as connected to parts and the functionality of a smartphone. You can see that we have 15 out of 25. So if you add the basic courses that are given in the first year, you almost have seen the full ECE program. Let's say that with this trip inside my smartphone, I covered many applications, but that is not exhaustive. There are also other applications, I listed some here, that are considered in the by the topics that you'll see during the ECE program, like fiber optic communication, photonics, or electronics for home automation, or microprocessor for supercomputer, signal and image processing that we have seen, for example, for application in the telecom, but could also be applied for medical equipment, or electronic system that are used for robotics and industrial automation. What is important for you to know is that in particular in our area, we have an hands-on approach. So wherever it's possible, there will be laboratory. So several courses, especially in the electronics and telecommunication, will have laboratory experience. Here I put some of the picture. There are both hardware lab, mainly for electronics. There are also computer lab for programming or for using design tool for electronics, design tool for communication system, and so on. Consider that more than 20-25% of our in the second and third year, you understand it is not the same in the first year because we have the basic courses, will be hands-on, so really labs. Another big opportunity that is important for students is the internship. During the third year, you can go through what we call professional training. So you can substitute one or two courses depending on your study plan and have a training for one full semester in a company. There is a dedicated Polytechnic office that is in touch with company that gather all these offers, and then you can choose the one that better fits you. Another important opportunity is about the mobility. Politecnico, as especially in the ICT area, has a long-lasting experience in mobility program. I understand that under today's situation is difficult to talk about mobility, but we must be optimistic, and we hope that the situation will solve soon. And I think this is not a problem for you that you enroll in the academic year 2020-2021, because the mobility program usually starts in the second or in the third year. So hopefully everything will be available for you. I want just to highlight the two special programs that we have in the EC program that are the Polyton. It's a double degree where students spend one full year in China, and then when they come back, they have the degree of Politecnico and the degree of Tongji University. And then the SecU program, that is a program in jointly between Politecnico and the University of Southeastern Conference, that are in the southeast of US. And in this case, students spend one semester in US. Now, looking at the opportunity that are open to the student that graduate in ECE, I have to admit that most of our students continue their study, so they don't go directly for looking a job, so but they continue in a master program, so what we call in Italian laurea magistrale, the second level degree that is 2 years. ECE students, graduates, can continue with any master program in the ICT area offered by our collegio, the ETF college. The natural choices would be three: the master in communication and computer network engineering, that is, let's say, in the area, on the broad area of telecommunication, we call it CCNE. There is another master that is in ICT for smart societies, that is the application of all ICT technology to what are smart applications, could be smart transport, smart energy, smart health, so everything that has to do with this type of application. And also, let's say, the more familiar electronic engineering. While looking on professional profile, when we designed the the ECE program, we had in mind some profile like the telecommunication system manager or digital signal processing system designer. So, but as I said, most of the students continue. So it's difficult to give you some statistics about employment if you just consider ECE. So what I did is to look at the results, at the statistics published by Alma Laurea, that is a consortium of Italian universities that made this type of statistics, for students that graduate in the Master in Communication and Computer Network Engineering. And you can see that the employment rate is very high, is always higher than 90%, so there is almost no unemployed. And also the time to the first job is very short, is about 5 months. So both data are in line with the average engineering graduate in Polito, and in some cases we are even better than them. So coming close to the end of this webinar, I want to highlight the ECE strengths. The first is that it's taught in English in an international environment, and this allows you to be ready for a job in ICT. It's an interdisciplinary program, so it will open to all opportunities, not just a very narrow, degree, but you can move from electronics to communication to computer engineering. It has hands-on approach, so you will learn by doing. And last but not least, we have small classes. I don't know if you already checked the numbers. We have about 110 students admitted every year, so it's not a huge class of students. So you can have a strong and effective interaction with professor. Other strengths is that in this period where Politecnico is fully committed to provide a good learning experience, also with the restriction of physical presence, that could continue at least partially in the next semester. Having small classes is a big advantage, because also in remote teaching you can have more devoted lecturer, easier labs, As I told you already in this past semester, Polytechnic had video lesson. We also activated several other channel of communication with students like chat. We had the remote laboratory. We have software license that allows students to use at home the software that you could use in our lab. And we even have been able to send hardware to the home. So like small cards or radio receiver to have the lab directly at home to perform the lab as you were at Polito. To conclude, the level of satisfaction, again, our official data taken from Alma Laurea, you can see that the overall satisfaction about the ECE in the last year is more than 93% in line with Politecnico, other Politecnico courses. So this concludes my talk. I want now to move toward the question and answer session. So you can keep going asking your question, as I said, in Italian or in English. In this webinar, I'm not alone. There is also Professor Roberto Caudino, that is the ETF, Collegio ETF Vice Coordinator. And
hi to everybody.
And Margaret Rosabrusin, that is a PhD student.
Hello, everyone.
Will help us to and the question and the answer. Today, I don't have with me, but maybe it will be in the next session, Oliviero, that is a student graduated from ECE program. During the Polito Open Days, you'll have other two opportunities to speak with us in case you will not be able to get all your answer today. The first one is tomorrow. From 3:30 to 5:30 will be available again with the same Sky Meeting platform to answer your question. This is the link. There is also a QR code. And again on Wednesday. Wednesday we will have also the webinar at 3:30, but I don't think this is interested for you because you are already following this one. But again, there will be 2 hours, some of us, to answer your question. Last slide is to let you know that we have also a Telegram chat, the ETF chat L3. It's not specific for the ECE program, so it's for the 3 degrees that are electronic engineering, electronic and communication engineering, and physics engineering offered by the Collegio ETF, okay? So you can also ask in this chat, starting from today and in the next day, and maybe we'll keep it open in the next months to give you all the info you need. Okay, I think we can move to the Q&A session because I'm a little...
Okay, we can break the ice with the first one. So the first question is, are there books for preparation of Polito admission test for engineering in English?
I'm sure there are books. I don't know if they're specific for Polito test. I know that there is a lot of material on the Polito website. So if you look in the Orientamento session, I think, let me verify which is the address. I can, maybe Margaret, you can look at the address and yeah, put in the chat. There are example of tests from past years, so you can have an idea of what type of questions. There is a lot of material, but I'm not sure about, let me say, commercial material from other sources, but maybe they are available.
Okay, so we have time for other questions, so don't be shy. Yeah, here we are. This is in Italian. So, in vista di un percorso magistrale esclusivamente trattato in lingua inglese, quanto è significativa indicativamente la differenza tra chi ha già affrontato i primi anni in inglese e chi solamente in italiano? I also translate in English. Basically, the question is, if I get the question properly, what is the importance of or the advantage of following already a bachelor degree in English, given that the following master degree will be mostly in English?
Yeah, in at least if you stay in Polito, but for sure if you go abroad, your master will be in English, because in the area of ICT, we only have a master in English. What I can say is that obviously if you start with already a bachelor in English, you get familiar with all the technical nomenclature, especially in the second and third year, about electronics and telecommunication in English. And also, even if we are not mother tongue, English mother tongue, you will for sure learn and improve your English. So some advantages will be for sure there, even if I cannot say that some students, that the students coming from ECE are better because of the English in the first level of their academic studies.
Yeah, by the way, I can add a comment on my experience. For the Italian people, don't feel worried about the fact that this bachelor is in English. Because as my colleague said, most of us are Italian professors, so we speak a relatively easy English. So normally our students never perceived particular difficulties in learning English. Actually, what they tell us usually is that they are pretty happy that basically for free, since they hear English all the day from our lesson, they improve a lot their English without feeling that this is such a difficult task. Okay, so don't feel worried about the English language.
It's a sort of free course that you have for 3 years. And not just by us, but also because you are, as I said, in an international environment. 50% of the students come from abroad, and you can only interact with them speaking in English. It's a big advantage for you to keep learning and improve your English. In the webinar.
In the meantime, for those of you who are on the chat, we wrote the link in which you can find a lot of information about the admission to Polito. Okay, while Amza maybe can try to write the question or try to speak again, but in a quiet environment, we can take other questions.
Is the bachelor, oh, sorry.
Only 3 years.
Yes, the answer to Vanessa is yes. The program is 3 years. We have 60 credits per year. So after you complete 180 credits over 3 years, you graduate. If you continue in Polito, and in case, let's say the unlucky case, you don't complete exactly the 180 credits by, let's say, the beginning of the fourth year, you are allowed to start your study in the master in Polito, and then you can complete, let's say, during your fourth year. So you can have a little overlap. You are admitted to follow the courses of the master, even if you are not graduated completely, let me say, in your bachelor. This is an advantage, because if you move to another university, this could not happen, because they want your certificate of graduation, and unless you graduate, you have to skip one full year and wait to the next cohort of students. This is typically an important information that you need to know.
Good. Other questions? Amza is asking to try again with the microphone. So let's try it.
So you have to first raise your hand with the icon, otherwise we cannot. Okay, he did it. Let's see. Try to speak. So Hamza, you can proceed with your questions. Are there any other questions while we wait Hamza to switch on the mic?
Yeah, a question right now. Can you add some more details about the mobility programs?
Yeah, let's add a couple of details about the two special programs, and then I will also tell you more in general. The Polytong is, as I said, a double degree, so it's a more important program. You stay one year in China, that is the second year. So you must apply during your first year, so during your first academic year at Polito. There is this is true for all mobility program. Every time there is a call for a program, you must apply, and there will be a selection based on merit. And okay, I don't know exactly what happened for the first year because you don't have probably yes exam passed, but they will do some type of evaluation of your career in order to get the student selected based on the merit. So as I said, Polytong is 1 year in China, the second year, and then you go back to Polito for the third year. The SEQ is a second semester of third year, it should be. And you can select between five or six universities that are in the southeast of US. There are also other programs that depends on year by year that are, let me say, more standard Erasmus program in Europe, so in EU country. Unfortunately, there are not many, but this is not, let me say, a limitation that apply only to my program, to ECE, because it's a sort of decision, a policy that we have in the ICT area, that most of the mobility happens in the master's degree, so in the second level, because typically in the bachelor, there is no, we think, so big advantage of having a mobility, and we prefer to send the students or to have more grants dedicated to students in the master, not in the bachelor.
Maybe I can also add that apart from the mobility program, Polito also have a sort of special program that in Italian is called Percorso Talenti.
Ah, yes.
That applies to all degrees, all bachelor degrees. And it's a very interesting sort of excellence course inside the normal bachelor degrees, which is allowed only for students that have very high grades in the admission tests. And the program is basically giving the student that follows it more detailed training. And if I remember correctly, also a strong deduction to the admission taxes. So I think this is a very interesting initiative by Polito. It's anyway parallel to the mobility programs. Good.
Yeah, so, I can also add one information because I was involved in mobility in the past year. There are also other Erasmus programs, for example, the traineeship, that are not specific of a degree. And Polito will have a call every year, actually a couple of them every 6 months. And for example, for the traineeship, you can select a company or a lab around Europe, in the EU countries, and you can spend your internship or your professional training in the company. This could even be after you graduate, so you could have in the summer between bachelor and master. It could be after master if you think it's better to have this type of mobility. So there are many opportunities. Some are specific of the course, some other are offered to all engineering courses, some other are even just are even, let's say, not exactly related to a course and are offered by EU program. I was looking if there are questions in the chat.
No, so yeah, if you have other questions, we can keep we can take a couple of more questions. Otherwise, if you want to think about questions, as Andrea said,
yeah,
there are going to be two other opportunities to ask tomorrow and the day after tomorrow.
Or use the Telegram chat or send the email to me.
Maybe, Andrea, you can show once more the slide in which there are all the references.
Okay, my email is here. Very simple, my name, dot last name. Remember that all this webinar is recorded, so you can view it again through the YouTube channel of Polito. And these are the link and the QR code to the Sky meeting that we will open tomorrow at 3:30 and Wednesday at 3:30 to answer your question. There will be also the students. So if you want to have a private chat with a former EC student, you can join this virtual room. And this is the link for the chat.
In the meantime, Margaret wrote in the chat the link to one of the Polito pages. And this is the test simulator for the admission exam. So I think that answering one of the previous questions, you can find a lot of information here. And I see that it is also in English. So yes, the answer to the first question is that there is some material also in English about the admission test. Okay, so
if there are no other questions, we can close the webinar here. And maybe you can come back to the next opportunity or just contact me by email.